Welcome to QuickBooks Online for Nonprofits. My name is Ufuma Ogaga. I am the owner of Goshen Bookkeeping and Consultant. I am a financial controller and a QuickBooks Pro advisor, helping nonprofits to increase profitability one mission at a time. In today's tutorial, I'll show you how to reconcile your books using the Reconcile feature in QuickBooks Online. To open the Reconcile screen, you want to click on the gear icon, then click Reconcile. Now in this screen, you want to match the account to the physical copy of your bank statement or your credit card. So in the account section, you want to choose the account that you want to reconcile. I am going to select checking account as my account to reconcile. At the bottom, you want to enter the ending balance and the ending date. QuickBooks will also show you the beginning balance. For my ending balance, I am going to enter 205486. In the ending date field, you want to make sure that the ending date and the ending balance matches your bank statement exactly. So in the ending date field, I am going to enter 12/31/2018. And before you click start reconciling, review the information one more time to make sure everything matches your bank statement or your credit card statement, and then click start reconciling. Now this is your reconciliation screen. At the top, you'll see your reconciliation toolbox, and you will see the statement ending date that we entered in the previous screen, as well as the statement ending balance that we entered. Here you will also see the declared balance, which is also the beginning balance of your account in QuickBooks Online. And you will see payments and deposits. Every time you check a transaction or you mark a transaction as declared, it will increase or decrease either the payments or deposit options. Now, QuickBooks tends to ask you, do you need more space to review transactions? I like to just check the box and say, don't show that message to get it out of the screen. The other thing that you will see on my screen, you have three main tabs. You have the payment tabs, you have deposit tab, and then you have your all tab, which is a combination of your payments and your deposits. QuickBooks Online automatically filters your transaction by the statement ending date. So if you want to see more transactions after that ending date, you can click the X icon to clear the filter. Now, the other thing that you will see on your screen, you have your date columns, you have the type of transactions, you also have a reference number, the account name that the transaction came out of, a payee, a memo, and payments and deposit. If you are using the banking feed option inside of QuickBooks Online, you'll see like a cleared date listed telling you that those transactions have been cleared. So I'm gonna try to reconcile my payments first by checking the box next to each transaction that have cleared my bank statement. And you can keep clicking each one separately, or you can pretty much scroll the way to the top and check the box to say yes, select all. Switching to the deposit screen, I'm going to repeat the same process by either checking single transactions or just clicking select all. Now, when you do click select all, QuickBooks Online is going to show a difference if all of those transactions did not clear your bank or your credit card statement. If you do have a difference, you need to save your progress where you are. We'll figure out why there's a discrepancy in your bank balance or credit card balance, or you can also click the edit information and maybe update your ending balance if that information is incorrect. So for here, I am actually updating my ending balance since this is a sample file. Once all of your transaction matches your bank statement and everything clears, your difference field should be zero. And once that is zero, the box at the top will turn green and say finish now. So I'm going to click on finish now to exit out of this screen. I recommend printing out a copy of the reconciliation report when you are done reconciling your books. Here I'm going to click on the print icon to print out this reconciliation report. I'm going to save the report as a PDF. Typically, you want to attach the report to your physical bank statement or your credit card statement or whatever account that you're reconciling. And I like to give my reports a good naming sequence. So I'm going to do 2018, December 31st, QBO checking account, recon statement. This way, if I ever do a search on my computer to locate that report, if I'm going through an audit for whatever reason, it's easier for you to find that information. That is a quick and simple way to reconcile your books inside of QuickBooks Online.